So welcome back to EEP 15, where we build a complete railroad layout. And as usual, I wanted to go over what I worked on in between this and the previous episode. So I moved those houses here a little bit to the across the station to alongside the track here, which this is not a prime location. This is a little bit cheap-looking tenement buildings. I think they fit in very well here, instead of kind of in a slightly nicer location over there. I introduced this bridge because I wanted to have a road access to my soda factory, which is here. I assembled this and connected it to the road. And you see that there is a invisible road where trucks can enter and just make a loop for so far and basically just leave here again at the gatehouse. And I put some plants out here, and I connected the soda factory also with a rail link. And since this is now elevated, and is it the same altitude or the same height as the street here? This is a little bit an incline, and I use this support wall here, which is kind of interesting. It has a nice texture, and it's supports actually that these beams and the bricks are almost, if you pick the right ones, they are almost horizontal, and these verticals are almost vertical instead of inclined by the angle. Then I connected defined a camera. That's how that looks. And you can then jump to a camera and directly look in a certain predefined direction if you so like. Anyhow, this railing of the soda factory connects to the harbor. That's something we worked on last time. And I played a little bit more around with the harbor. I added this oil depot here, some more cranes, this bridge crane here, some buildings, and I also added this additional track outside here that goes to an area where perhaps liquids and food-related items can be loaded on ships. I'm not sure if that makes sense. If they are kind of bulk goods like grains or soda that are not perishable, that should be okay. I also finished the harbor wall here and let it disappear into the bank of the river. Extended the river a little bit up and down. And somehow I have to think about how I let ships disappear in the distance, if I so wish. I think that looks now a little bit more realistic than before. I'm not finished yet, but also the trees, I just put some out here to see how it looks. A lot of work still to be done. The last thing I did beside the harbor and the soda factory is I worked on the track for this side track, for the side line, branch line, that you see appear or disappear here in the distance, and it is as an incline. It's sloped upwards. And in the past, I had real problems doing that. It is not very well explained anywhere how to build this properly. And I found for me the best thing is to place a track just into the air, and then after the fact, go into the 2D view, grab the track that is in the air, kind of just like this, and then align the land around to the level of the track instead of the other way around. To me that sounded more natural, but of course then you have to kind of landscape very accurately before placing your track, and it never works out, obviously. And that's a little bit left. Now the railroad is, of course, on a thin ridge line, but that can be adjusted, and we can, or I can at a later moment go in here and landscape the remainder to the surroundings so that there is kind of a hill where the railroad goes up here. And I adapt the surrounding terrain to the existing track. So, boop, how does it look now? If you go into 3D view, now we get this very sharp, rough-edged ramp, basically, where our railroad goes. Of course, that doesn't stay, so we left here towards the west. Further increases in altitude, just slightly, just a rolling hill, perhaps. And here the land lowers to the level of the soda factory. And this kind of here is in a valley. I was thinking about letting a little creek go through here, but I don't really know where I let it disappear. There's just too much track, so probably I skipped that. And I think also the other branch line will be handled similarly. It will also go to slightly higher ground, and I will landscape this. So that looks nice. What I wanted to do, though, today with you is starting the first road here along our train station. And there are two ways of building roads. The first is just picking a road spline, going here to splines, and then go to roads, streets, and just take any street design, it's just, again, graphics, that you like. Just an example, this one. And it has often already a walkway in some fashion and the road. This is a rather minor street. And there are some roads that are by design kind of looking a little bit worn out already. Oops. However, in front of the train station, I did not want to do that. I clicked accidentally on the manual. Instead, where am I? What I wanted to do is just use this walkways and then paint the road in between the walkways and use these walkways to build them, to build bus bays. Then we have a lot of flexibility how we color the road. Actually, I wanted to build this as a cobblestone road. And this squarish cement tiles are kind of what in the 60s and 70s pedestrian walkways, at least in Germany, looked like. I remember this. This is already cobblestone, and I'm not sure if cobblestone beside a cobblestone road looks so good. That is kind of a newish design, this stone, and that is the same. It's already a cobblestone. So I thought if we pick this one and delete these designs, which would have been alternative choices. And then I leave a little bit space. I think I go for this walkway in the general coordinate system of this tile pattern in front. Even though the railway station is now not aligned to the road, it is kind of set back. There will be here a little plaza, basically. And then there is a road that will go here and then curve around here. For the moment, I delete all the cars. We don't need them. Move this away. And thinking about where we will have our bus bay. Perhaps somewhere here. Leave a little bit more space here. Just like this, perhaps. Like this, and then I add a small piece to it, shorten it to just a few meters, I'm not sure, let's say try 5, And A, this direction is, well, I hope that's right, 45 degree. Yes, something like that. And then add another piece to it. But do the opposite angle, like minus 45. And continue straight for a while, which will be here our bus bay, basically. That is not my design. I learned this from another YouTube video in German by the channel Wolle158, which is excellent. If you speak German, go there. It's fantastic. If you don't speak German, it may not help you all that much. This way. And then go to properties. Makes this a little bit longer. I don't know. 40 meter. And then we do the same thing again. Whoops, that may be a little bit long actually. Sorry. Yeah, 40 meter for a bus station. That was nonsense. That was nonsense. Let's make that 20. And then add another. Object properties, 5 meter long and minus 45 degree. Same again. It takes me always a while to find those, I apologize. Then go to properties, plus 45. And then we can continue with our walkway. And across the street, we do exactly the same thing for the opposite direction. So, come, think. 0. I'll just make it now a little bit longer. I'm not really sure what I do with this road. Eventually, this bridge will somehow connect to this town. Yeah, that looks good. What I would like now to do is to see if there's enough space or how far away I have to do the opposite walkway. So that we still have, that is not a four-lane highway here, that is a small city street. So I just place it here for now. And what we do is we put invisible roads in between. And then we put just some texture on top. And then we have vehicles that can drive there. So, where's the invisible road? Splines. Streets. Invisible street. Wonderful. Something like this. Now the funny thing in EEP is that most vehicles that drive on these roads drive not really on top of them, but slightly offset to the side. I think I make those a little bit thinner, just that they, when we later have intersections and things like that, that they don't interfere with each other. They look here like the walkways and like everything else. And if you have multiple things like this lying around, it becomes really confusing. Go on street. Move this to the right, just by 2 meter. Boom. Yeah. And now we put two buses on here and see how they look. And how much space is required. So I go to rolling material. Trailers, buses. Now these buses look, well, actually this bus is almost believable for the 60s or 50s. No, 50s maybe not, but there's actually a lot of space here. You see that the vehicle is not on the road, it's offset. And this one we turn around, boom, there's plenty of space. So we can actually make those tracks and the roads much narrower than they are right now. Oops. Yeah, yeah. Thank you. Lesson number one. If you put those tracks too close together, they auto-snap. It's better to have them a little bit offset. Like this, perhaps. Then they will not auto-snap. So, something like this. Don't want to make it too narrow either. Try that once more with the buses. And then adjust this walkway so that they comfortably fit. This bus on here. Another bus on here. Turn it around. And dive it a little bit backward. Looks now funny with all the road. A little bit more into the middle. Yeah, let's not get too close here. Take this bus off. Move this yet a little bit closer to the center. And then this is about symmetrical. Does this look right? Last test. They certainly have enough space in the middle, but they don't have enough space, in my opinion, to the walkway. Not really, not with the mirrors. So what we can do is put them almost on top of each other. And then move this a little bit further out. I said last test, but I was lying. Of course, we make one more. So here is now enough space, I believe. And here we can push simply this thing out a little bit more. I think we have a comfortable width for our road. And what I do now is I extend this a little bit more. Yeah, it will be tricky. It may be even better to make the opposite bus bay a little bit at a different location, not just across. I will see. So I move this down to not get the annoying effect of the snapping if you don't want it. And now I extend this, or actually I make this a two-way switch, which sounds funny while I wrote. And extend this. Not sure, we just moved this track. Extend this once more. wood here. Turn it around. Path comes from here. Let's see what is a good location for the start of the turnout here. That is already a two-way switch. That's great. Boom. To the first one we connect back there and make it a normal track. So. Oh, actually, I hope I didn't extend the wrong track here. So, probably not. Extend this once more. This will now go into our bay. Given that our vehicle is quite a bit removed from the sideline, maybe the track can be here. Something like this. And I get an odd feeling that my turnout wasn't placed very well here. Something like that, and same here. Oh, now here's the bus. Each time there's a vehicle, you can't do anything. I just connect this here. Make this a curve. Go to 2D. Use the closed gap feature. He doesn't like that. Can you do the other side before we correct everything? Yeah, can do this side. How about now? Yeah, now you can do it. Next test. So, on this side, there. Okay, once more. So, Yeah, I get it. Oh, I don't know why that happened, but it readjusted itself. So. Okay, it's still cutting the corner on this side, so I have to adjust this on this side. I do this offline because it's getting boring, and I will also do this side by myself. But I thought we look together quickly at the available cobblestones and see what we have to make this in between look kind of good. And we have concrete. Stones, paving, cobblestones. Well, they're different designs. Let's go through them. Maybe something like this. This? this. I'll try this first and see how that looks. I'm intrigued by this. No, gotta go painting, of course. Not even bad, I think. Yeah, it's just for the fun of it. Let's try another one. So this was, we'll find it by, how does this look? Just do here a little bit in the back, and then we can compare both. It has almost a greenish hue. Let me just see if I can adjust the color. I wanted to have it grayish more and not greenish. I hope I'm not colorblind here. Darker. No, it's completely on the gray here. That's weird. It must be eye. That's a little bit too dark. Still not happy with that. Better. Well, I'm not sure if the initial wasn't the best option. Though from the pattern, I think this is more realistic. That is kind of more a very fancy pattern that you'd see on a plaza. I'm not sure if you would see that on a road. So I think I go with this one. The good news is that underneath the walkway, we have a little bit of room and we don't have to be so accurate with this. So, yeah, perfect. So I will work on this roads. I still kind of, it must be an optical illusion. I see something greenish here, but I asked somebody else if it's just me, my monitor, or what that is. So, also play a little bit with scale here, by the way. What if I make it smaller? Becomes coarser. Maybe also not bad, because they probably didn't use the smallest stones for those big roads. And then that is good. I think I put the intensity almost to zero, that it is more uniform. Yeah, I can live with this. That's okay. And then further away, once we are not at the train station area, we can adjust. Then we can adjust the road and go back to one of those default roads as we had them elsewhere. I think last time I made the movie way too long, so I wanted to make it shorter. I wanted to just show this road building with the paving and the sidewalk. And thank you for joining me today. And have a great evening. And hope to see you next time around. Bye-bye.